Nuclear power plants around the world work on the principle of nuclear fission, wherein an atom is split into smaller atoms, accompanied by the release of usable energy. Nuclear fusion is the opposite of nuclear fission. What you might not know is that fusion is actually a better bet than fission when it comes to generating power. First of all, nuclear fusion requires significantly less fuel than fission. Fusion is also carried out by using deuterium, an isotope of hydrogen, as fuel, which is quite abundant in nature. In contrast, the fuel necessary for fission, uranium, plutonium, or thorium, is very hard to get and insanely expensive. Furthermore, unlike fission, nuclear fusion does not produce any radioactive waste, only helium atoms. Since fusion doesn't produce runaway chain reactions like fission can, there's practically no risk of a meltdown when utilizing nuclear fusion. The obvious question then is, if fusion is so great and better than fission in so many respects, why aren't we using fusion to produce power already? Well, there's not just one, but multiple things that have stopped us from using nuclear fusion to reliably produce power. One of the biggest reasons is that its energy requirements are unbelievably high. In order for fusion to occur, you need a temperature of at least 100 million degrees Celsius. That's slightly more than 6 times the temperature of the sun's core. Experimental fusion reactors do exist and work, but they consume far more power than they produce, thus defeating the purpose. Not only is the energy requirement for starting a fusion reaction unbelievably high, but it's also difficult to find materials that can withstand the reaction. For example, you need a special material that won't be affected when it's heated to such high temperatures. You would also need a lot of excess energy to keep the fusion reaction going. In addition to that, you need a very complicated, intricate, and densely packed setup to house the entire reaction. Fusion reactions also produce high-energy neutrons that hit the reactor walls. The layer of the reactor that faces the plasma is called the first wall. This sort of radiation causes most alloying metals used in steel to become radioactive. As of now, we don't know exactly what materials we should use to build fusion reactors so that their walls continue to withstand the extreme conditions they will experience. Last but not least is the money problem. Anything related to nuclear power is usually considered a tough idea to sell to the masses. Betting on nuclear fusion is like making a multi-billion dollar investment with no guarantee of success. There is also a social stigma around nuclear power that makes many believe that nuclear energy is bad. First, there's the notorious danger of radiation. This is further aggravated by unfortunate incidents like Chernobyl and Fukushima. The truth, however, is that nuclear is one of the cleanest and safest energy sources available to us today. Unfortunately, we are years away from making nuclear fusion a technically and economically viable process. Once the power of fusion is tapped and controlled, though, we won't have to worry about running out of power, ever.